Hello to my beautiful friends, and welcome to a new video. Tonight, I really felt like painting my nails. I'm not especially good or talented or creative, but I thought that I would let you guys relax and do this alongside me. These are my hands. For those of you who have never seen them before, not very particularly special or interesting, but these are my hands nonetheless. I had on some glittery nail polish earlier, but I took most of it off. There still might be a little bit, but hopefully not too much. So, since it's been a while since I've actually done my nails, and there is a helicopter going by my apartment, I'm gonna start by clipping them a little bit as you listen to the soothing sounds of the Air Force Base near my home. Some of you guys said that you enjoy the atmospheric sounds, so voila, enjoy the atmospheric sounds of the helicopter outside my window. So I have these nail clippers here. They are sparkly and gold, not real gold. They make a pretty simple sound, I think. Let's see how they sound if I clip my nail. Is that shocking or is it soothing? Maybe one over here. And a little on the side. There we go. Lovely. Not too much work is needed there. Let's do this hand just a little bit to make it a little bit more organized for our purposes. And then there are little pieces of nail. Beautiful. Little soothing pieces of fingernails. Here we are, almost done. So now, we are nicely trimmed all across the board. Now, since I did use nail polish remover, I do think I want to use some lotion on my nails and my hands. This is one called Dark Vanilla Coconut Hand Cream. I got it from my sister for Christmas, so I'm going to use that. Ooh, it smells very nice. See how it feels. That's the true test of lotion. So there we are. Lotion makes a neat sound, I think. And there we are. Nice and ready for polish. So, quite a few different colors that we can use. I'll show you guys some of the ones that I picked out. I have this very bright, pretty pink that has flecks of gold. I have this sort of baby pink shade here. I think it was like $4. It was very inexpensive. I have this Hello Kitty glitter. I just thought it was really pretty back when I got it. Let me see, I'll pull up the focus there. There we go. Maybe that's a little better. Perfect. I have this sparkly blue that has like a holographic quality to it. Sort of a marine blue kind of color. It has flecks of green in it. It's really pretty. And sadly, it doesn't look this bright when you put it on. looks really nice inside of the container. But I have a trick for that I'm going to show you. We've got this one with blue and pink and purple. All those colors. I have a green, if you like Christmas, which is only, how many months away? I have this. Looks like crushed gems, which is probably why it's called raw gem. And then this one, which is actually a liquid latex that you can put outside of your nails if you're a very messy person. And then when you finish painting them, you can peel it off and it helps keep them nice and neat. I learned about this from a YouTube channel called Simply Nailogical, which is very fun to watch, I think. So, what color should we do? Haven't quite decided if I'm going to show you both hands, since I am right-handed, so naturally the left will look nicer, and then the right hand will look not as nice, since I'm just not as steady with that. And I want to try and be a little bit creative, I suppose. So, let's start with this pink. I really like this pink color. I think I got it from H&M, I believe. Yeah, it says H&M right on the label. It makes a nice sound, I think, too. Alright. Let's try this one on my thumb here. I'll try and make sure you guys get a nice view, as well as me, so I can see what I'm doing. Use a bit more polish there. I remember that when I was little, my dad told me that he was very good at painting nails since he grew up with a bunch of older sisters. So I have memories of him sort of showing me how to do it, which was really sweet. There's no shame in being good at painting nails. Regardless of who you are, I think it's a good skill to have. Me, I'm not so great, but I do enjoy it. So, there we go. We have a pink fingernail. Look at that. Perfect. Pink. Alright, so what should we do next? I think I'll probably end up adding maybe some white designs to this one. Let's see. Maybe we should do a lighter pink next. Ooh, or this blue. Yeah, let's do the holographic blue. Okay. This one's really pretty. Someone actually sent me this one off Amazon, so I didn't buy it myself. Let's see here. I wonder if you guys will be able to see how bright this one is. It's a little hard to. Webcams kind of deteriorate the quality of things in real life. Like, it kind of looks just like a blue, but I promise you it shimmers. I'll probably have to take some photos afterwards and put them here, so you guys can see a little better. Now, I think what I'd like to do next is do the pink shade that we have. So it'll be like bright pink, light blue, light pink, and then go back to the previous color again. So let's do that. Here we are, bright pink. This one isn't quite as pretty as the others, but I think that we can do something really fun with it. It's also a much cheaper polish, so it will probably need two coats. At least two coats. There we go. I'm not gonna just hold up the middle finger, because then I'm gonna flick off the webcam, and we don't want to be demonetized any more than we already are. We are already demonetized. option here. I can make this finger pink to follow our pattern, or I can make it blue and this one pink and sort of do a centered look. You know, I never see that done, so I kind of think I want to do that. What do you guys think? I think that sounds really cool, so I'm gonna do that. So, this one blue. We'll get our blue color here. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And paint this fingernail. There we are. Da, da, da. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Beautiful. There we have our little powdery blue. And last, we have our very bright pink. There we go. My pinky nail is so much smaller that sometimes it can get hard to actually cover it and not the rest of my hand. There we go. So that's our start. Different shades. Pink, blue, and then the light pink in the middle. Now we need to let that dry for a minute, of course. So, naked hand, colored hand. I realize you guys can see my legs too. I promise I am wearing shorts. They're just maybe while we wait for the first coat to dry. A lot of you guys said that you enjoyed the blowing sound. Can you hear the tapping if I do it here? What if I do this? I think we're ready almost for a second coat. After that, I have to think about what I'll do. I really want to try and do some designs with this. It's just a super thin brush of white. Oops. Which actually, if I do that, I think I might not need a second coat on these two. I think I might stick with the one, but I definitely need a second coat on this pink. Something else I wanted to show you guys that was really cool that you can do actually deals with glitter polish. So, you know, I showed you a bunch of glitter colors that were really pretty, right? And sometimes if you just stroke the glitter across the nail, it doesn't come off as glittery and bright as it is in the tube. Well, we want to fix that. So, watch this little trick. You can take a sponge, any kind of little sponge, and then you are going to paint it with your glitter polish, like this. Just like that. Now, what it hopefully does, that what it's supposed to do, is absorb some of the liquid and leave behind more of the glitter chunks. So, let's see if that works. Okay, if I don't get glitter all over everything. Let's try. Ah, look at that. That's kinda neat. Okay, let's see. Managing not to get it all over my hand. Not too much, at least. So that trick, it worked, but it didn't work as well as I think I wanted it to. So I think what I'm gonna do is go back in with this and get these other parts. I definitely did get a lot of glitter there. More than I think I would have gotten otherwise. Oh my goodness. So this finger just kind of looks super glittery and messy. Oh my gosh. It's so sparkly and it's really clumpy. Okay. So what I've determined is that either this nail polish is too clumpy because I've had it forever, or let me do my autofocus. Look. Oh, come on, you can do it. I believe in you. Oh. 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 Nope. Nope, webcam says no. How about that? Can you focus then? So we just have a very glittery finger. Very chunky glittery finger. But I'm not mad at it. It's not bad. It's not great, but it's not bad. I wonder if it would be different with the less chunky glitters. Let's try it with this one. Let's see, okay. So we'll take the same. Oh look, all the glitter is off of this. Try with this one instead. Paint it. See how this one's not so bright? I really wish it was, but alas, it's not. There we go. Okay. That's a lot more. Okay. Let's try it on the blue. See that? Okay. It's kind of hard to tell here, but do you see how much more glittery it is than this one? Now let's compare it to if I just go like this. One swipe. Yeah, it's not quite as glittery. Look at that. So much more sparkle than this. Definitely like it better with the sponge. We're learning as we go, you guys. We're learning as we go. So, I'll just dab it on like that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Much better. Okay, much more sparkle. So, I wonder what kind we can use on this one. Maybe we should try this one. This one's so pretty. really like it. But I wonder how it'll translate onto the light pink. Let's give it a go. We'll use this side, which we haven't used yet. Okay. The brush for this one is so tiny. It's hard to get on a lot at once, but so for this last finger, let's revisit our chunky glitter friend, but I think I'm just gonna actually put it on a normal way, not the fancy way. So we'll do it the normal way and see. Yep, see how chunky that is? You don't need the sponge. So the sponge works best for glitters that are just very more transparent. The more opaque you get, the less likely you're gonna need a sponge to see that glitter. Okay, there we go. Beautiful. There's Fancy Mama Foo. I apologize for my thumb not being quite as nice, but I think once we start adding the white, it'll be a lot cooler. Let's see. Look at that, I can zoom. Ah. And I can focus. I wonder how focused I can get. Oh. Beautiful. Look at that. Okay. So next up, we're gonna do this white. I wonder what kind of patterns we should go for. Now my only rule is you're not allowed to make fun of me if I'm not very should start with, like, I'm kind of nervous. It's a little hard to see, but maybe I should do some stripes. What do you think? All right, let's try. I'm gonna try a stripe. Oh, yeah. Do these same stripes on this hand, or we can go diagonal. Let's go diagonal. Oops, there we go. Perfect. Then one more diagonal this way. I'm actually really surprised how good that came out. like candy canes, in a way. It's not Christmas, but we are inspired. Okay, next up we have the blues. What kind of pattern should we do on the blues, do you think? Let's see here. What if we were inspired by, like, starbursts or snowflakes or something? Something like that, like a line here, then like a line there, and then there, kind of like they're coming towards the center, if you know what I mean. Like a starbursty pattern. I honestly think it looks kind of neat. Let's try the same on the other one. So, that way. There we go. These ones look a little closer together. A little less haphazard, I think. There we go. This is shaping up to be pretty interesting, I think. So, now we have the last one. What should we do? We've done lines, starbursts. Okay, don't make fun of me, but I'm gonna try something. Really thick or is it thin? The black one is the same size. Okay, good. That's what she said. Alright, so I'm gonna need a little concentration here. Catch the drips there. Okay. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna make an even line. Oh my gosh, I like it. I actually like it. It's really cool. We have a Triforce on this finger. I repeat, there is a Triforce. I'm gonna color it in. Okay. I hear the train. You probably hear the train going by. doesn't look quite as nice colored in, though, does it? I don't think it does. Let me see if I can add some white to the center. I need a little bit more black. Okay. There we go. There we go. Da 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 da. Kind of. Okay. So it's not beautiful. That means I need to add some black to the rest of these fingers to kind of even things out, I suppose. So let's see. Don't trip. There we go. Okay. Da, da, da. Alright, that's kind of cool. Let's do this one. Right, that is that is definitely something that I have done. Definitely something. Let's see how it looks. So, if anybody asks if I'm good at doing nails, I hope that you all know that the answer is no, I'm not. But I think that's okay. I think they actually look kind of neat. In a, I pity these kind of way. There's the autofocus. I don't know if it's gonna properly focus at all. But, well, it kind of did that time. I really need to get an actual camera. I do that. It makes it jump out of focus. Like, wait. Oh my goodness. So, this is what they look like. And this is my naked hand. You can see the comparison. We have a dark Triforce and some starbursts and stripes. The question is, should I paint this hand to match this one? Or should I take off this nail polish so I don't get fired from my law office job? What do you think? I hope that you guys enjoyed this silly video. The purpose was not to be a nail tutorial or anything like that. More so just to be me being myself with some sounds and talking and things like that. If you enjoyed this video, leave a thumbs up down below. I'll leave a comment. Tell me what other weird stuff you'd like to see me try now that I have a tripod here for my webcam, and subscribe for more, and I will see you guys in the next video.